recently I've been, I'm not big on, you know, the web and everything that much, but I noticed that there were some times in the past that, you know, Kenyans and Nigerians had a little war on the web. It was sad. You know, and Nigerians did the same thing with Ghana, did the same thing with South Africa. But the thing is this, let me tell you, let me just break this down. Do you know that, let me ask you, who created borders? Who came up with the idea, border, this is my land, this is my area? Nobody knows. We grew up to meet borders. We grew up to find out that there's Ghana, and there's Nigeria, there's Togo, all those places. For crying out loud, we are all black, but the ancestors, old school mentality, they wanted their own area. It's fine, it's okay. But do you know that Africa will be stronger if we're all one, not just by mouth, by heart? Do you understand? So I like what's happening right now, the fact that I'm here being loved by you people, and I believe, and trust me, comedians from this part of Africa, they're also coming down to Nigeria, and they have also been well accepted. And one thing I'm going to tell all the comics right now, I've just realized that comedy is actually the easiest way to integrate people. You understand? Which we are going to start doing very soon, because this part, like South Africa, they deported some Nigerians like last year that they don't have yellow fever card, which is stupid, because I've never seen any Nigerian with yellow fever, the disease. I've never seen anybody diagnosed for yellow fever. You understand? It's only malaria, you know, finish. You understand? And they deported, and they flew them back, you know, and Nigerians were pissed off. And the thing about Nigerians is that we are kind of ruthless when we do our own, when we want to pay back. You know what happened? So the South Africans, they now came the next day. The flight landed. They deported every South African, even the ones with yellow card. And guess what? They didn't put them on a flight back. They left them at the immigration area for 2 days. And the guys like, we want to go back. They said, then go. Which, you know, at the end of the day, everything got settled and everything is fine. You know, but I think we should just stop all the stuff. Yes, Nigerians, we have our own issues. I'm Nigerian. I know we're loud. You're very loud. Well, it's a typical thing. People are like that, you know, that there are some loud Kenyans as well, Ugandans, you know. But the things are our own. We just do it too much, and I hate it. You understand? Nigerians were so loud, and they always use that same word. Do you know who I am? So annoying. Do you know who I am? Are you okay? Do you know who I am? Who are you? That's how one Nigerian missed his flight. He was flying back to Nigeria from the UK. He missed his flight. And just by 5 minutes, and he got to the counter, like, this is my passport, I'm flying back to Lagos. Like, sir, I'm so sorry, sir, but the flight is closed. What do you mean? Sir, the flight is closed. Do you know who I am? Will you put me on this flight? Do you know I'm a chief? Do you know who I am? Do you know who I am? The woman was like, wow. And she just carried out, you know, white people, they're funny. She just carried out their stuff.
Excuse me, there's someone here that does not know who he is. Can you just get someone?
White people, they don't care. One thing that white people invented was they invented flight, flying. Back then, we used to use horses. The white people, they made things easy. You understand? We need to give them props more. They invented flying. Right now, you can now use your phone while you're in the air. You can browse. It's crazy. It's beautiful. And there's this thing that they do that I love. When the pilot comes on the phone,
ladies and gentlemen, this is pilot speaking, and we're going to be cruising on an altitude of 30,000 feet above sea level. And we're going to U-turn.
They make it sweet. They make it, you know, it's nice. It makes you very comfortable. I know the black people, we also started doing it, but our own was just so sluggish. Have you ever heard a black man, a black pilot, making his own?
Ladies and gentlemen, this is your pilot speaking, and my name is Captain Yusuf Ibrahim, and we're going to be cruising on an altitude of what altitude are we cruising on? Yeah, 20,000 feet. 20,000 feet above sea level. And,
and the white people, I like the way they do. They go like, and the weather outside is so clear, so calm, so nice. The weather outside. We are 30,000 feet above sea level. You are telling me about the weather outside. Like, I have intentions to go for a walk. Who does that? Bill Gates doesn't have a private jet. He still flies commercial. Our own people, small money, private jet. The white people, they don't spend. See the guy, we are all here. You guys are all seated, eating, enjoying yourself. And guess what? I don't know how much they paid, but you guys probably paid 3 or 4 times more than they paid. And guess what? You guys are listening to the same jokes.